So how important attitudes is with children. How important emotions are a connection, a deep connection with our children versus our head. Okay, so this, just to wrap this up, to one of the most powerful parts of the class is being connected again with one of the most powerful parts we have about us, which is our emotional side, our feel side. And then the last one. Pretty flawless, wouldn't it? Okay. What drives how you feel? If you've ever been upset, if you've ever been frustrated, if you've ever been mad, if you've ever been numb, if you've ever been bored, right? Is life boring? No, you are. True? Life is not boring. Cannot be boring. We can be bored, but life is not, right? So, interesting note there. So, what drives all emotion? If you've ever been upset today, if you've ever been stressed today, if you've ever had anything of a negative emotion, it all comes from one place. And it's the way you and I, this is our mental nature, mental, emotional, right, physical. This is our mental nature, how you perceive things, your perception, your strategies, the way that you see the world, the way you see men, the way you see opportunities, the way you see growth, the way you see, because you have a perspective about everything. How many of you, when you put your toilet paper roll on, how many of you like to have your toilet paper roll off the top? How many of you like to go more back behind and then down the wall or some of those? How many of you, your preference is neither, you won't even put it on the wall? See, you have a preference of how toilet paper should be, and there are some people that will fight about that. No, it is supposed to go over the top. I was doing a class with this, and it's fine, whatever your perspective is. Just look at your perspective because it generates everything else. So I'm not here to say there's a right perspective at all. It's just to explore them. And this one thing goes, it sounds like you're saying that going over the top is wrong. I apologize. I don't know. I'm not saying it's wrong. Because it feels like it, and it's not wrong. It's right. It is the other way. She came back to the class the next day with paperwork. And she got on the internet where she found when they first started making toilet paper and they had instructions of how to do it, it was off the top. And she was clear that I was wrong.
I mean, that became really best friends though.
And she saw, this is how I do everything, isn't it?
What was that?
She's like, why do I do that?
And she's figured out why it's fabulous, okay?
So, perspective. You have a perspective about everything, and your perspective absolutely dictates if you're happy or not. Does that make sense? Your perspective dictates if you're sad, bored, tired, numb. This is the one that's in charge of it. You don't change this one, you change this one. You change this, this changes, and this changes automatically. When that happens, we're producing different results. When you can just take a look for 3 days at how you see the world, how you see, you might be sitting there going, no, I've got a pretty good grasp on that, you know? And what I'm going to say is that you've got a pretty good grasp on about 10% of your perception, because the brain is designed to have about 10% that we're aware of and 90% unaware of. So we are most unaware of perceptions. We've had them for so long, we don't even see them. And that's what you'll see in the class is, well, no wonder I'm producing this result. No wonder my women in my life would leave. I never understood it was because of perception. I never said anything. It was how I operated with the relationship. Have you ever heard this? You can have a great relationship or you can be right. Have you ever heard that before?
Yeah.
How powerful that is. You can have a great relationship or you can be right about it. Don't get both. And what I saw was that was my perspective always, that I had to be right. So for me to be right, you had to be what? And I found what's wrong. A smile on my face. I think we're going to turn left up here. She said, no, I think we turn right. No. I said, no, we turn left. I've done it before. He's right. She was like, I do think it's on the right. I'm like, oh, okay, we'll see. True story. Can we drove down? There's no resort there. What did I turn left there to say? Both you. Do that many times in a day. Does it start to erode the intimacy? Absolutely does. People will even have kids to have make them wrong. So that we can always validate how right we are. You know anybody who loves a debate and loves to always have the right answer? Right? There's a price, there's an effect on it. When we get to see, why do I do that? It's powerful when we can see it and then not do it.